I will bless the Lord at all times. His word shall continue to be in my mouth. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we all have come tonight to rejoice in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. In the words of our pastor that comes from the Bible, he would say, if you can bless a giving God, you can also bless a taking God. And so we bless the Lord here tonight. Let me take this great, great Wednesday evening to welcome each and every one of you to the Greater Exodus Baptist Church. We are so, so delighted that you have decided to join us in this worship experience here today. We trust that you are going to just let loose, open your mouth, clap your hand, and let's worship the living God here this morning. Praise and worship is going to give us two selections, and after which we will follow our program at hand. Let's worship him. Let's worship him.
Come on, we're going to just worship this morning, this evening, and we're just going to start off with this. I will bless the Lord. Come on, sing with me. Oh, my soul. And all that is within me. Come on, bless his holy. Come on, lift your voices. Lean in. Come on, lift your voice and sing with me. I will bless the Lord. Oh, my soul. And all that is within me. Be blessed, his holy. Come on, lean. Come on, one more time. Come on, lift your voices. I will bless the Lord. Lord, oh my soul. Within me, bless his holy. Come on, let's turn it. Bless his holy name. Bless his holy. Holy, bless his holy name.
No matter what I have to do, 'cause I need no matter what I have.
Cause we need you more and more. Is that anybody's testimony? I'm chasing after you. No matter what I have. We wanna see you, Lord, more and more. I'm chasing after you.
I'm chasing after you.
No matter what.
Just to be closer.
chasing after you. More and more. We want more of you, Lord. Thank you, praise team. Good evening, precious people of God. Our scripture this evening is coming from Matthew, the book of Matthew, the 15th chapter, starting at verse 1. It reads as follows: I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purgeth, that it may bring forth more fruit. Now you are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine, no more can you, except you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. He that abideth in me and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me you can do nothing. If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch and is withered, and men gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you shall ask what you will, and it shall be done unto you. Herein is my Father's glorified, that ye bear much fruit. So shall you be my disciples. As the Father hath loved me, so I have loved you. Continue in my love. If you keep my commandment, you shall abide in my love, even as I have kept my Father's commandment and abide in his love. These things I have spoken unto you, that my joy might be remain in you, and that your joy might be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friend. You are my friend if you do whatsoever I command you. Henceforth I call you not servants, for the servant knoweth not what his Lord doeth. But I have called you friends. For all things that I have heard of my Father, I have made known unto you. The Gospel of John, 15th chapter, verses 1 through 15. This is the inerrant word of God. Glory, hallelujah, praise God. Amen, amen, and amen.
Amen. Thank God for his word. Worshippers may enter, worshipers may enter. As worshipers are entering, we are preparing, as we normally do on Wednesday night, we are preparing for our offering. And so what we say here at Greater Exodus, it's time to worship God with our gifts. Amen. Preparing for offering. We ask Reverend Johnson to come and ask the Lord's blessing upon our giving at this time.
Shall we pray? Dear eternal God, we your people have assembled in this place simply because you're God. And oh God, as we prepare to give, you are able to look into the hearts of man and assess and know and awareness of where we are in our hearts. And God, as we give, let every heart be touched. Because God, we can't beat your giving. As a matter of fact, you've been so good to us. We ought not have to ask for us to give, because God, we should want to give, because the more we give, the more you give. And so God, as we complete this prayer, we want to thank you for giving us our pastor. Hallelujah! You gave him to us, and you called him, and his was his name to answer. So God, we've been taught, so let us give like we've been taught. We celebrate you, Jesus, and we shall give. As long as we have breath in our bodies, we're gonna give. And as we give our finances, we also want to give you the glory. We want to give you the praise. Touch our preacher, our presenter tonight, that as he give from his heart, that we would be receptive. This is my prayer. I pray it in Jesus' name. And let the people of God say amen.
Living up in the streets, and the drug habits, some say they just can't be. Muggers and robbers, no place seems to be safe, but you be my protection every step of the way. Thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me.
Thank you.
With the tragedy.
Thank you.
thank you, Lord, for all that you've done for me. Yeah, well, thank you, Lord. We're going to have the praise and worship team to come and give us a selection. After that selection, you will hear a word from Reverend Herb Lust III. He's going to share a word. And following that word, we'll have Pastor Cofield, one of the sons of this church, will come and pray for us. And then Reverend Johnson is going to come and give us direction for outside. Amen. Let's worship the Lord.
In times like these, how many can say, I need a living God? I need a living God to rescue me right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. He is Lord. Every knee shall bow and tongue proclaim Jesus, wonderful Jesus. You are Savior, you are Lord, and you are my God, Yeshua.
We love you.
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 worship.
What you done?
I worship.
Always in control.
I worship.
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 You're worthy.
You're worthy.
You're worthy.
You're worthy.
Continue to give God praise all over the house. Come on, Jesus is the center of attention right now. Come on. Come on, let everything that have breath. Let everything that have breath. Praise the Lord. I don't care if you got a mask on your mouth or you don't, you better open up your mouth. And say thank you. Oh, thank you. What y'all waiting on? What y'all waiting on? Go. They ready to worship. Let's go. That's what we're going to do. We're going to worship. Y'all heard what your pastor said. He said, when I die, shout. Y'all sitting up here looking at me like I'm crazy. Ain't that what he said? Because he's healed. Y'all ain't talking to me. Thank you. y'all come to have church or look at me? Which one? If you can't say nothing, lift those hands. Be the glory for the great things that he has done. Amen. Amen. What's up, Greater Exodus? Y'all all right? All right. It's so good to see everybody out tonight. And preachers, I appreciate it. You may be at ease now. Amen. Y'all can take a seat. Amen. God bless you. Y'all ain't gonna sit down. I know that. Y'all gonna stand with me. Amen. Amen. Listen, eventually I will be able to respond to all of those texts and things everybody's been sending. I was looking for my sister. My sisters, they may come later, but on behalf of my family, we feel the love. Amen. Amen. We feel the love. Amen. 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 God bless you. Glory be to God. Before I get to that, I want to thank Reverend Flores and come on. Yeah. Amen. That's right. Give honor where honor is due. That's what the Word of God says. Give honor where honor is due. And I've already had this conversation with him in private, so he already knows what I'm going to say, but I wanted to say it in front of everyone. I appreciate you, and I thank you. And you know, it's not just how you took care of my dad, but it's how you took care of me. Amen. And how you helped raise me. And I am eternally grateful for that. Give God a hand clap of praise for Reverend Flores. Amen. And the list goes on and on. What's up, Joe? Amen. Reverend Johnson. I got to do this before I preach because I may be too emotional, y'all. Got to do this. Listen, if I wasn't in that house with my father, if my sister, if our family was not there, Reverend Johnson, come here, man. You know what I'm going to say because I've said it to you privately. But sometimes it's good for people to publicly know. They don't know the weight that this has been.
And you have helped shoulder the load. You've helped shoulder the load in so many ways. And so I thank you. Thank you, man. Give God a hand clap of praise for him. Where is our... Where is our chairman at? Where is he? Hey, I'm not going to ask you to move, man. I'm going to try to do this one without crying. Hear me. Hear me. There was nothing that my father or our family ever needed that he did not grant it. A man that is fighting pain himself, who was in pain himself, but has been faithful. And I'm going to do this quickly because I know you're supposed to do this at the end, but I don't know where I'm going to be emotionally at the end. But to these deacons and all of our preachers, come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. We thank God for them and what they have meant. And certainly, what can I say about my uncle D.Z. Cofield, who has inspired me without even his knowledge of his brilliance, but also his humility. I thank you for your friendship to my father. I thank you. I want to thank God for Pastor Hatcher, who allowed us, hear me, Daddy is going home in style. We're going to have that service at the Met. And we thank God for Bishop Hatcher. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Now listen, I got a lot of people to thank, but I can't do it all tonight because obviously we wouldn't get no word, and we need a word from the Lord. And I got so many people to thank, and I'll get to you, I promise you. I'll get to you. I'll respond to every last one of them. Great Exodus, you know how I feel about you. I've been here my whole life. And so I've been here my whole life. I don't know any other church but you guys, and I'm grateful for every last one of you. As I prayed about what would be said tonight, the Lord led me to what is need to be said, and I only did it one time before, but I can hear my Father's voice. As he was speaking to me, as I was thinking, and the Holy Spirit confirmed it in my spirit. Let's go to the book of Acts. And I've heard my father preach this message a few times, and well, not a few times, this is one of his, the preachers will know what this means. This is one of his horses. Amen. And where we are right now, we are in a serious storm. But God will navigate the waters. Rest assured that he will navigate the waters. He will navigate the waters. Uncle Boom Boom, is that Boom Boom back there? That's my dad's old teammate. Bless you, man. Amen. Amen. Andy Autry, God bless you, man. Amen. Acts 27, 21 to 25. We're going to be brief. because I know if my little nephew is here, they just want to let the balloons go. Lord help them. They ain't worried about nothing else. I wish I could go back to them days. They said, yes, balloons. They're all excited. Yeah, we're going to let the balloons go. Amen. Acts 27, 21 to 25. And this is because he's still our pastor. Amen. Let's not get this thing twisted. Amen. He's still our pastor. Amen. But after a long abstinence, Paul stood forth in the midst of them and said, sirs, ye should have hearkened unto me and have not loosed from Crete and to have gained this harm and loss. And now I exhort you to be of good cheer, for there shall be no loss of any man's life among you, but of the ship. For there stood by me this night the angel of God, whose I am and whom I serve, saying, fear not, Paul, thou must be brought before Caesar. And lo, God hath given thee all them that sail with thee. Wherefore, sirs, be of good cheer. For I believe God that it shall be even as it was told to me. I believe that's enough for today. Let us say amen to the reading of God's word. As I said that my father has preached this message numerous times, as I've watched him preach revivals and I've watched him go all over the country and preaching this scripture, there's no doubt in my mind that it's very fitting at this moment. Although we were just smiling and reminiscing about things that have happened, it is not lost on me, Doug, good to see you. It's not lost on me that each of us right now are heartbroken. We are perplexed. Some of us are even confused. There are those who may even be angry. There are those who are so hurt that they will not even express their feelings. Matter of fact, there are some folks in this room right now who are on the verge of even breaking down in the sanctuary. But here's the great thing and the promise that we have. No matter what the challenge, no matter what the storm is, no matter what the issue is, there is always a promise with us that he will never leave us nor forsake us. And it is not lost on me, and I told you this whole 27th chapter is dedicated to a storm. And right now we're being rocked in the storm of life. I like you, was shocked when I got the news that was happening. But I want to tell you that while we are listening to this message, while we are going through what we're going through at this very moment, you need to understand that if you cannot see that this tragic, this catastrophic thing that has happened is not a storm, make no mistake about it, it will hit you eventually. Here's the reality about life, is that there is no time that a storm is appointed. Storms are continuous. And the thing about a storm is that it comes at no notice. There are always these perplexing seasons of life. But I want you to rest assured tonight that there is a reason for you to rest and be still. I told you what your pastor said a couple weeks ago. The last sermon he preached was, matter of fact, the first one, he told us to be watchful. God, I can't hear nobody in here. He told us to be prayerful. He told us to gird ourselves up. Because God had already spoken to him. But he was getting us ready for the days that were ahead. And right now, we are right in the midst of the storm. But I got news for you. There's a reason that you can smile through this storm. There's a reason why I still got the strength to be able to preach even after a couple days ago. It's a reason why I didn't think about having suicide as an option. There's a reason why I'm not locked up in my house. There's a reason why I can stand with my faith. It's because every promise that God has made is yeah and amen. Is there anybody who can believe that tonight? That God is true to his word. Look at somebody and say, God is true to his word. Now you ain't true to your word, but God is true to his word. You changed your word on me 2 minutes ago. But every single thing that God has said to me in his word is already settled in heaven. Is there anybody who can say, I'm resting, I'm crying, I got a hole in my heart, I'm missing my pastor, I'm missing my friend, I'm for my siblings, we're missing our father, my nephews are missing their grandfather, but my mama's missing her husband, we're missing our pastor, but God is in control. And if my daddy was here, he would say the reason why we can rest is because we got this greater promise. Oh, yes, sir. Oh, yes, sir. Somebody say that greater promise. What, y'all scared? Y'all talk back at me. We're going to have church. We're not coming here to act all cute. Okay, now, okay. A greater promise. See, the other men on the ship, they didn't have the promise that Paul had, which is why they were panicking. Let me see if I can help you out. The storm of life that we have now with the loss of my father, the city is panicking. The country is panicking. But those who are children of the Most High God. God, y'all gonna play tonight. Okay. Those who have a relationship with Jesus Christ, we're not wondering where our pastor is. We already know. Because we got the promise. The promise is to be absent from the body. God, y'all ain't saying nothing to me. It's to be present with the Lord. So even in the midst of the storm, we can say, it's all right. I bless him at all times. I may be confused, but I'll bless him. I may be hurting, but I'll bless him. 1 Kings 8:56 says that none of his promises shall fail. None of us. My father would always say something like this. People are always looking for explanation. Quit looking for explanation. Just walk in your faith. He's promised. He's promised that he's be there. He's promised that he's answer our prayers. He's promised that he will heal us. He's promised that he will protect us. He's promised that he'll give provision. He's promised he will walk with us. Look at somebody and say, I'm not going to be discouraged. I'm not going to be disgruntled. I'm not going to be deceived. I'm not going to doubt what God is getting ready to do in our lives. But then daddy would have said not only a greater promise, but he would say a greater patience. Oh God, my father used to always tell me all the time. He would say, son, wait, be patient. Wait on the Lord. Be still. God, I heard what Moses said. He said, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. The Egyptians who you see today, you will see no more. Can I help you with something? I know right now you are sowing in tears. But the other flip side of that is that they that sow in tears shall reap in joy. But the only way you can reap in joy is if you're strong enough to be patient. Is there anybody here that can say, I got the patience? I got the patience. I understand what Romans is saying. Romans said that we glory in our tribulations. We know that the tribulation works the patience in our life. And we got a hope that is not disappoint us. Right now, our church, our family, we are in a Garden of Gethsemane experience where everything is collapsing inside of us. But I got news for you, but they that wait upon the Lord. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength, and they'll mount up with wings like eagles. But and they'll run and not be weary, they'll walk and not faint, but you got to wait on them. Look at somebody and say, not only do we have a greater promise, we got a greater patience, but then we got a greater peace. Somebody say, I got the peace of God. I got the peace of God. See, why Paul was sailing in that storm, the reason why he wasn't tripping is because he knew he had to make it. He knew there was an assignment on his life. He understood that the word of the Lord had come to him. And that's what I'm trying to explain to you tonight, that you got to have that peace of God that guards your heart and mind. It surpasses all understanding. Y'all wondering how I'm making it, because I don't understand how I'm making it, but it's because his peace that surpasses all understanding, it's guarding my heart and it's guarding my mind. Look at somebody and say, I got a greater peace. Be anxious for nothing. Don't be anxious. Don't move. Just stand. Just stand. God's got it. I'm at peace. Oh God. But then church, he would always say, not only do we have a greater promise, not only do we have a greater patience, but we got a greater purpose as a church. Can I help you out with something? I know this storm is hitting us. I know you're heavy. I can see it all over you. But my father was very clear to me. He said, son, the church, the kingdom does not revolve around one man. See, that's what's wrong with certain people. They think it revolves around them. But they don't understand that the church was already surviving before they got alive. And even when they go, guess what? The church is still gonna be here. I tell you what my daddy told me before he passed. I called him that Sunday and I said, Dad, I had to preach. I said, Dad, I want to come home. I should be with you right now. I don't feel right. I got to come home. He said, no, boy, uh-uh. He said, no, you don't come home. He said, you're on assignment. He said, you're on assignment, son. He said, you got to stay focused and handle God's work. And when you understand that you got a purpose, it is not relegated on who is there or who is not there. It's relegated on the fact that God has spoken it. So if he's given you something, no matter what's going on in your life, no matter what you lose, you got to learn how to walk with it. You got to learn how to go through it. You got to learn how to press through it. Then we had the purpose. We had the purpose, but then we had a persuasion. Oh, Paul was poised. God, I'm almost ready to shout here. He was persuaded nothing could stop him. Death, sickness, loss. He was persuaded. He was convinced. He was convinced. And that's where you got to be right now. To come hell or high water, I'm convinced that God is with me. No matter what I lose, I'm persuaded. I'm persuaded. That's what Paul said. I'm persuaded. I'm persuaded. I'm persuaded that nothing can separate me. That there's nothing that can take me away from his love. There's nothing that can fracture our relationship. If God be for us, then who? Oh, somebody been to Bible study. If God be for us, then who shall be against us? Or what shall be against us? He was persuaded. He was going forward. But I got to tell you, in order to have this thing right, and this is the tough part, because we're in a storm right now, church. And I'm looking at some of y'all right now,
And I know you won't get to the balloon send off, and we're going to do that pretty soon. We're going to throw them balloons up in the air. But there's something else that we got to do in the midst of a storm. And my father said that there's a greater peace, there's a greater purpose, there's a greater promise, there's a greater persuasion. But here's what we got to do now. Because we know all that, we got to have a greater praise. And I don't know about how you feel about it tonight, but David said it like this, that I will bless the Lord. God help me here. At all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. Y'all excuse me for a minute, I'm done. Lord, help your boy to do this thing like I feel it. God wants us to worship no matter what's going on in our lives. I know that our pastor is past, but we still serve a great God. And the mark of a true believer is not how you praise God when everything is going right. The mark of a true believer is not how you do things when everything is what you want. But God wants to see if you got the same faith no matter what's going on in your life. And can I tell you something? When David said, I will bless the Lord at all times, he was not in the palace yet. His life was on the line, but he still knew that God was with him. And I'm wondering, is there anybody here tonight that's willing to stop looking at me like I'm crazy? Y'all already know I'm spiritually crazy. So let's come on and praise God in advance for the great things that he shall do. And I'm trying to tell you, open up your mouth and praise God. We still serve a great God. We serve a mighty God. No matter what is going on, no matter what the tests, no matter what the storm, no matter what the tears, we know that it's working together for our good, because we love him and are called according to his purpose. Is there anybody here tonight that wants to lift up their hands and say, thank you, God? Can I tell you something? When Job lost everything, the Bible says this, that he tore his robe and he got down on the ground, shaved his head, and began to worship. I wonder, is there anybody here tonight that will worship God even though we lost our pastor? I know that your heart is heavy. I just lost my daddy. I just lost my best friend. But I'm going to praise the Lord at all times, because his praises shall. Somebody say shall. Shall continually be in my mouth. Somebody say yes. Say yes. Say yes. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me. He shall hide me. He shall hide me. Y'all, this is where you prove that you really love him. Look at my sister. She lost her daddy, but she's still worshiping. What's wrong with y'all? Worship God. get them hands up. Come on, push me with everything you got. Come on. Come on, worship. 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 Have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. Healing is taking place. Deliverance is taking place. Transformation. Hear me. We've been taught for 40 years. We've been taught the word of God for 40 years. Let's not revert because it gets tough. My father said, son, handle your business. Handle God's work. Stay focused. I'm saying the same thing to you. I know the storm. It's blowing. We can feel it. You see the tears in our eyes? We can feel it. But we will believe what we've been taught as children. My sister up there, my sister here, my cousin Haley up there, my family. We believe what we have been saying for years. Your witness cannot just be when everything is right. My dad said, son, it's easy to preach when everything is going right. Can you do it when you're sick? Can you do it when you lose family members? Can you do it when you're heavy? Can you do it when you feel betrayed? Can you do it when you feel hurt? Can you do it when you're hurting inside? Can you do it when your mind is messed up? And I'm saying to you, I need your prayers. My uncle is coming. He's getting ready to come up here and pray in a minute. But I got to, there's one form of business. I got to do this because I was taught I cannot make the assumption. My grandfather and my father both, they said, son, you never make the assumption that everybody in God's house is saved. I ask you to stand to your feet. Is there one? Listen, you want to know how I'm making it? It ain't because it ain't my own strength. You want that same, you want that same thing? You gotta have a relationship. I'm not talking about no plaything. I'm talking about a real serious relationship with God. Because he'll get you through the storms. Is there one today that desires to give their life to Christ? Listen, life is but a vapor. You don't know. Don't be saying, I'll wait until next month. I'll do it when I get ready. I got to get right first. Can I help you with something? Ain't nobody ever gotten right enough to come to Christ. Is there one? Is it one?
Lord, bless him in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Is there one? It's all right, nephew. Don't cry. Okay. We all right. Okay. Is there one? Listen, don't wait. You don't know. Don't listen. Don't let nobody fool you up in here. If you do not have a relationship with Jesus Christ, you better come now. Is there one?
Lord,
is there one?
I'm available to you. I will like you.
Uncle, it's in your hands right now.
I'll do what you say. Use me, Lord, to show someone. Sing along.
Change the mission that we're on.
Yeah.
Over the last 3 years, 4 years or so, I've had a chance to spend so much quality time with Pastor. And he said some stuff to me 2-3 years ago, before he was diagnosed, that he was ready. And I told him, I said, Pastor, why are you talking like that? You're talking like a crazy man. You sound like Job's wife. And he said, no. He said, man, I'm ready. Just a couple of more things I need to make sure are in place. I wanted to make sure Sister Vicky was provided for. Wanted to make sure his children were good, his grandchildren were good. And I got to tell you, Greater Exodus, he wasn't worried about Greater Exodus, he said, because they're in good hands with Herb. They're in good hands with Herb. They're in good hands. He just had a peace about him that was unbelievable. I want to read something to you. It's the last words of Steve Jobs. Steve Jobs was the founder. You may be seated. Steve Jobs was the founder and CEO of Apple. Everybody complained about how tough Steve Jobs was to work for. So much so that the board got rid of him, only to have to bring him back when the company began to flounder. At 56 years old, he died. Here are the words that he spoke. And I believe these are the words that our pastor can speak as well. I have reached the summit of success in the world of business. In the eyes of others, my life is a success. However, aside from work, I had little joy in the end. Wealth is just a fact I am used to. He said, at this moment, laying on my hospital bed, remembering my whole life, he said, I realized that all the gratitude and wealth in which I took so much pride has vanished and became meaningless in the face of imminent death. You can hire someone to drive your car or make money for you, but it's impossible to hire someone to deal with sickness and die for you. Material things lost can be found, but there's one thing that can never be found when it is lost, and that's life. Whatever life stage we are in, with time, we will face the day the curtain closes. Love your family. Love your spouse. Love your friends. Treat them right. Cherish them. As we get older and wiser, we slowly realize that wearing a $300 watch or a $30 watch both give the same time. He said, whether you have a $300 wallet, a purse, or a $30 wallet, a purse, the same amount of money is on the inside. He said, whether we drive a $150,000 car or a $30,000 car, the road and the distance are the same. Today, I want us to pray. First of all, let's thank God for our Pastor Herb Lust III. Let's thank God for him. Come on, we can do better than that. Let's thank God for him. My God, my God, my God. How many of you know he stood in the power of God tonight? How many of you know Herb Lust II would be proud of him and what he did tonight? Stand on your feet if you will. Let's pray. God, we thank you today for the life, the love, and the legacy of Herb Lust II. We thank you, God, because we are part of the fruit of his labor. We stand as a testimony that this man lived, love God, and loved all people. And we thank you for bringing him into each of our lives. We are the better for having known him. We are the better for having been taught by him. And God, he reminded us that the seasons may change, the servant may change, but the sovereign God of the universe remains the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. God, we will miss our pastor. But God, we know to be a believer, you're in a win-win situation. Because God, in your words, you have said to live is Christ and to die is gain. And your servant Paul said, if I stay, I'm not staying for my sake, I'm staying for your sake. We thank you, God. I pray, God, that that same anointing that has been on this church for its history and over the last 40 years, Holy Ghost, I pray that you would rest, rule, and abide amongst this people now, henceforth, and forevermore. We pray, God, for the leadership and the fellowship, and that in the midst of it all, that we would give you the glory. Hallelujah. 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 Glory. God, as I close this prayer, remind us all, as empty as our lives will be moving forward without him, help us to realize how emptier our lives would have been if we never knew him. In Jesus' name we pray. Come on, let everybody say amen. Come on, give God some praise in this place. Hallelujah. Glory to your name.
As we get ready to exit and depart, come on, let's celebrate God for our preacher tonight. I have been instructed to give us some directions on what we ought to be doing as we leave the sanctuary. First of all, the family has asked me to just let you know that our pastor will be lying in state here on Thursday in the morning, 8 o'clock in the morning, all night leading into the day of the homegoing, which is going to be on Friday the 30th, September the 29th, next Thursday, I'm sorry, not tomorrow. Lord, let's fix that. The 29th and the 30th. Our pastor loved us. Yeah, come on. Yeah. And he requested that should something happen to him, he wants to be in the sanctuary. And so, all leaders and officers, we ask that you be on post and on standby. We need as many folk as we can to honor our pastor. And so, on Thursday, he will be lying state here in the tundra, as he would call it. And then on Friday, at the Met. Pastor Hatcher is the presiding senior pastor there, have opened their doors. And what's the Met? Service will begin at 11 o'clock. Oh. There's going to be a viewing from 9 to 10:30. Viewing is from 9 to 10:30, and this is on Friday. And so we ask that you get here early and position yourself, because we know that we have limited parking, but we pray that you would be mindful and prayerful for this family. We're under the leadership of our chairman, of our deacons, and we've been instructed today that in the midst of all of this, God has a way of speaking to us. And if you think about the season in which God called Pastor's name and he answered, was leading up to our church anniversary. And a few weeks from now, he will be celebrating 40 years. Yeah. So with that said, talking to our chairman and talking to Reverend Flores and Pastor Herbie the Third, and we talked about the biblical text about fire and how God used fire. When he met Moses, he used fire to get his attention at the burning bush. It was on fire, but it wasn't consumed. When the people were in trouble and God delivered them out of Egypt, he led them in a cloud by day and fire by night. And Jeremiah said that it's like fire shut up in my bones. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego would say that we were in the fiery furnace, but we didn't get burned. In the book of Acts, it said that when the Holy Ghost came, it was just like fire clothing tongues. And in Revelation said, Jesus had fire in his eyes, flame of fire. Why are we talking about fire? You see, it was fire that started Pastor on his way. And so as we kick off the anniversary, we have balloons, which symbolizes the very fact of God's fire. Because God's fire cannot be consumed. And so as we kick off, because our pastor will be proud of us, as we kick off this 51st church anniversary, we collectively, which will demonstrate our unity, because anybody who ain't on board, I'm praying for you, the devil is alive. We're going to stand together. And so we ask carefully, and that everyone who can apprehend a balloon, stage ourselves, because there's fire in the room. Don't be careful who you stand by. You might get burnt up. But in the parking lot, stage yourself, because we wanted to do this structurally where that we all can grab hands, and it's too many of us. So wherever it be, wherever you can find some space, find that space, get a balloon. And Reverend Herbert III would give us instructions, and at a certain time, we will release them. We will release them. But let us be orderly, patient, and wait for instructions thereafter. But how many are glad that we had a pastor who served us for 40 years? So come on, let us celebrate our anniversary together. Stand to your feet. I'm going to turn the mic back over now. Did I make any sense to you? I don't want to have to go through this again. Amen. You know, some folk are listening, some folk ain't not. So just, if somebody look like they know what they're doing, just follow them. Amen. Somebody fake it till you make it. All right. Come on. Who's coming next? Come on.
And Chairman, to my understanding, sir, we are releasing these out front, correct? Okay. So when we release these balloons, we'll be out front. Amen. Amen. I wish I could call every name. Rich, I love you. Thank you. I wish I'd call every name. But everybody, we're getting ready to close out. Please don't leave. Please don't leave. Please don't leave. Please don't leave, everybody. We're getting ready to close. We're getting ready to close, okay? I know everybody's restless, but we still need to give a benediction. We got to close out in decency and in order. Amen. That's what we've been doing for 40 years. We're not going to change that. Amen. We're going to be in decency and in order. Amen. I'm going to ask you to stand to your feet, and then we'll be out in the front to do these balloons. Listen, don't be afraid to hug my family. Love on them. Listen, and I need everybody to hear me. It's not just me going through this. I'm his son. But hear me. Before you say anything, hear me. It's not just me. I have a mother. Okay? All right? I have a mother. I have a mother. Okay? You gotta love on her. I got two sisters up there. One right here. Got another one up there. Love on them. I got a little cousin up there. Love on them. Our whole family. Okay? My nephews, everybody, okay? They all need the love. All right? Let's pray. Father, we thank you for tonight. And we thank you for what we have seen and what we have heard and what we have felt. And we thank you, God, for your promises, for they are yea and amen. I pray right now, Father, that you move by your Spirit. Protect us and preserve us. And please grant us provision for the days to come. And as my Uncle DZ said, we thank you, God, for his life, our pastor, his love, his legacy, his labor. We thank you, Father. Bless us and keep us in Jesus' name. Amen. You are dismissed. God bless you. But we're letting those balloons out there. Get on out there. God bless you. I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. Hey guys, don't bring those balloons in the sanctuary. When you get them, go straight out front, leave out the ramp, all right? Leave out the ramp, leave out the ramp. There's some in the fellowship hall. But don't bring the balloons in the sanctuary. Y'all keep on jamming over there. Bless you. Bless you, band. Jam real good, real good.